What's up, guys? This is Coach Donny from Elevate Yourself, where we change lives through volleyball, training, and inspirational content. Welcome to my volleyball coach reaction to Haikyuu Season 4, Episode 14. If you're new to this channel, I'm a volleyball coach, volleyball player, and personal trainer who provides volleyball tutorials, jump training workouts, and other volleyball content. I'm glad you guys enjoyed the special halftime show from the last episode. I definitely plan to make the halftime scenes a little bit more interesting with my own content and some special announcements, so make sure you stay tuned for those. Thanks for explaining the symbolism behind Inarizaki. I think I pronounced that correctly, or simply Inari, the Shinto shrine and how they're represented by the fox. This actually reminds me of some of the old school Japanese television shows like Voltron or the old school Power Rangers, where each person or team is represented by an animal. And I think that's one of the cooler parts of watching things from Japanese culture. Thanks for clarifying such great detail about the variety of animators that are hired for each episode. According to your information, 15 to 20 animators are hired for a particular episode, and each group of animators is dedicated to different segments. And that makes a lot of sense if you're trying to pump out an episode once a week. What's really cool about doing these reaction videos is you're learning about animation and illustration from my educational and experience background, but I'm also learning about the anime industry and how the business works and cool details like the number of animators and how companies are paid per frame. I appreciate all the background info, not just on Haikyuu, but the Japanese culture and the anime industry. Now let's get this Haikyuu party started. Da, 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 da. Why does that song sound so familiar? Is that a intro for Inari? But how do I already know that? I've only heard it once. Must be a reference from something else. I gotta be able to do that one day at a real volleyball game. Everyone's frozen. That must have been the easiest scenes to animate. The replay of the clean ace. If you can get it past Nishinoya without any reaction, that's how you know it's a clean ace. Ooh, Kageyama. Look at that smirk. Let's compare everyone's facial reactions. We have Daichi, Nishinoya, and Tanaka looking surprised and shocked. You have Hinata. He looks surprised but in a positive way, like ooh. And then we have Hinata, or Kageyama, with the grin. And it's interesting that Kageyama and Hinata were the only ones of the Karasuno team that we can see that were actually excited about this level of competition, and I can definitely relate to that. When I was younger and I used to see people perform hitting lines, bouncing the ball, or watch other teams roof the crap out of other players, I used to get intimidated. But as I got older and got more confident, I now get more excited because it's a chance for me to test my abilities against better players or more athletic players. But that did take a mental mind shift. It took a lot of work for me to develop that type of excitement. And I had to always tell myself whenever I would see really athletic players bounce the ball, my initial reaction will always be, oh no, they're gonna destroy us. But I had to practice talking to myself and say, this is my chance to see if I can block them and dig them, and when I do, I'm gonna go nuts. I encourage all of you to practice that type of mentality when you notice the competition is intimidating. Man, that bracket looks amazing. Just so organized, so clean. Ooh, they're pitting Kageyama versus Atsumi. Is that a flashback from when he misses again? Oh yes, it is. Everyone has that look. Oh, I don't remember that scene here. I must have a really short memory, or if this scene didn't stick out to me last time, but this illustrated scene has such great contrast with the shadows. It kind of reminds me of the mangas that I used to read and the illustrated novels where each scene was soaking in so much detail. You almost felt like that scene was animated because there was such movement in the line and the textures and the shadows. And this is a great illustration here. Ooh, even Atsumu was encouraging. That's another anime sound. Oh man, that's... You absolutely suck. It's funny how Atsumu, who's not even his teammate, is encouraging him, but Kageyama was the one putting him down, of course. Nah, Hinata's gonna be able to click. It's one of those unrealistic anime moments where someone does something new and takes a long time to change. Oh, this intro looks different. We're gonna check this out here. Beautiful sunrise rays with the crows coming out. Alright, they had to use some CG for that sunrise. Oh man, we gotta zoom in on those crows. These are some really cool panning images here. I think it's cool that they don't show the faces of these characters to make it a little bit more mysterious. Is that Atsumu? You see that aura coming out, and I know I keep referring to this character, Akuma. For those who've been watching my channel for all these years, you guys know how many Street Fighter references I make because I love Street Fighter. I call that the Akuma aura. Just such intense energy coming out of your body. And I know that happens in almost every anime. Some sharp movement there. That scene right there with the panning, where you're panning the background is flat, so that's shifting here, but the fact that you have to rotate the body for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 figures, that means you have to draw probably 20 to 30 different forms of the back of Atsumu's shoulders. Like, if you can visualize each frame, you have to draw a different image of the same one rotating. And it's super smooth here. Who's that muscular guy? Is that Kageyama? I think this is a particularly exciting intro because it's pumping up the national tournament. Oh, that was sick. That's like an anime poster coming alive. When I was younger and I would buy the Gundam and Dragon Ball Z posters, one thing that stood out to me from the Japanese anime posters and the Marvel comic book posters that I was also a fan of, the way they utilized the vertical templates was on another level, and how dynamic those images were. Whereas a lot of the Marvel comic book posters, some of them were vertical, but they just looked like vertical images. They didn't have these dramatic perspectives, but the horizontal posters from the Marvel comic books were amazing, where they illustrate these really cool action sequences. So I want to enjoy this vertical poster coming to life here. That's so beautiful. Just a layer. And it's not just images coming in, they're kind of moving too. And that ball taking the place of the iris. Are these sequences that are going to happen in the game against Inari, the new K-pop twins? Yeah! This is just some cheesy moments in anime. I'm going to try to voice over this scene from, I think that's Atsumu. All right, you guys gotta time it with me. Ready? Take your fist. Yeah. Oh, even Hinata does it too. The funny thing is, just imagine if people acted like that in real life. Episode 14, Rhythm. This is like the Yamaguchi look-alike here. It's funny how each team has similar people from each prototype. Is it just me, or does that look like Yamaguchi? And then there's another team that had a bald player. I think it was Nakoma, who has a bald player similar to Tanaka. I wonder if that's on purpose, or maybe these directors or creators run out of ideas of different types of people, because we probably have to come up with 200 to 300 characters for this entire anime. Yeah, that Area 5 scene is really difficult. Good high swing. Oh, he's gonna set him on two? Yes, he is. Oh. That is a modern technique that's happening right now. Setting on two. I wonder if Karasuno is gonna adapt and try to do it right again. To try to set on two. Nice key! It's funny how even the teammate was caught off guard. That's the right mentality to have. Bokito wanting to prove himself. Just wait until Hinata does his feet quick. That's some cool hair. Who is that guy? Why is everyone so upset at Inari? I mean, they just made a great play. Are they gonna do a skyball? Oh, they're messing with the rhythm. Ooh, Kageyama hitting on two. This is some good animation this episode. I'm looking forward to it. Oh, the hesitation switch. I think it's funny how you have two different reactions from twin brothers, and they seem to be identical twins because they look very similar, just with different hairstyles, which I appreciate that they called them twins, but it's easy to identify them differently. The one in blonde hair looks excited about this type of level of volleyball, and the other one looks like caught off guard. Another sign that Atsumu is a true competitor. I love that Kageyama Hinata says, "Oh, you could do that? Well, look what we can do." And this background music is really cool. It's like a house track. He's charging his Super Saiyan power. Oh, they're standing so cool with their shoulders open. But they can't show it. Everyone's trying to act like they got it under control, but they're thinking something else. That's not truly a slide because he is jumping off of 2 feet. I gotta check to make sure that Hinata was jumping off of two instead of one. Okay, so yeah, he is jumping off of 2 feet. So a true slide attack is where you're jumping off of 1 foot going behind the setter. And I actually have a detailed volleyball tutorial video if you want to learn the proper slide footwork and how to run a slide attack that you should try with your friends, with or without a net. See if you can do a slide attack like Hinata. Even though this is not a slide attack, you should still try it. Sometimes the fans can be wrong. I'm not talking about you guys, the fans in the audience. Alright, the darker hair must be the older twin. Man, booing. Come on. That can't be real in Japan. Oh, I like that. Tsuki is just zoned in. We don't need the memories. That's such a weird slogan. Can someone explain that to me? There we go with the zombie illustrations. So I can't tell if Hinata's excited or nervous. with a slow clap. This never gets old. Okay, maybe they're trying to mess with the rhythm of the server. These are cool tactics. Oh, but you get a dribbler. That's still pretty good. The sidestep, is it gonna hit it? Oh. That was a very accurate. Did he just run the middle? Alright, the reason why Kageyama is so fascinated with that first step is because as setters, to be able to execute a very good set, you usually need to get your feet directly under the ball. But that doesn't always happen because passes don't always give you enough time, and so the really good setters aren't always the fastest setters. They're very good at positioning their feet directly under the ball, and that starts with reading where the ball is going to land and also trusting your body's instincts to move, because if you commit too early, you're going to be wrong and the ball is going to be in a weird position and you're going to be forced to double or make a very inaccurate set. So that's what's special about that first step, that he can really position his body well before the ball gets to him. And if you do watch volleyball, that is really what makes a sign of a great setter. Not necessarily how accurate their sets are, but how efficient they are with their feet, their decision making, and their feel for the hitter's rhythm. Because a great setter might not always set the same spot at the same time, because a hitter will not always have the same timing and the same hitting location all the time. But even if Kageyama's impressed, then that's impressive. Oh, he did run the middle from there. That is very similar to Maruf from the Iranian men's national team. A lot of people just take one or two steps, the good setters. But if he can do it on one, he must be pretty tall. This is an exciting match. Zoning out, look at that perfect passing posture. I like how this episode is going deeper into the different rhythms of players and managing the flow of the game. Oh, did Tanaka just hit it on two? That was pretty ballsy. I'm gonna tell you another secret of the animation industry, or a tactic that animators use. I swear I've seen this animation of Nishinoya sliding on his right knee, shooting his pop to the side, and then separating his platform and having the same exact flow. The funny thing is, his technique looks exactly the same on a perfect pass as it does on the overpass. So here's the secret. When there's a specific scene that either looks really great, or maybe you just want to be efficient with time, animators will actually retrace older scenes and use them in different episodes. And you think about how much time that saves. You're probably saving yourself 20 to 30 images that you have to draw of a very complex movement. And then all you have to do is have the person color it over with a different uniform color. So here we just have the switch between the orange and the blue. And then you can overlay that particular sequence over a different background. And I'm pretty sure they've done that with Hinata, so I gotta keep an eye out for that. But for sure, this Nishinoya clip, even you see how his left hand is lower than his right hand. I guarantee we rewind back to other episodes, this exact same movement of the ball. And actually, this is the international ball that they're using too. And he kind of bends his elbow upward. That's a cool cheer. Yeah, I want that long trench coat. That looks pretty warm. Wonder why she commented on her staring. Ooh, that's a nice perspective drawing there with Hinaka. I said Hinaka, Tanaka, presenting the ball there. Mm-hmm. Yep. especially right before a serve. My prediction is Karasuno is going to struggle in the first match and then they're going to come back. These are some great animations, super smooth. They're rushing the server. Yeah, you feel rushed. You really do have to block out and breathe and take your time to go through your whole routine. That's interesting serving progression. He's crouched down. I like that they do have a variety of service rhythms. Oh, and another killer ace. That was like a spike from the service line. Aran. I gotta memorize his name. Alright, I'm not zooming in on food this time. I am zooming in on these musical instruments. What's really subtle about this scene is you have those very detailed images of these trumpets or these French horns. I don't know what they are. For the band geeks out there, feel free to correct me. To show that they're omitting sound, the edges of the trumpets, or the, I'm just going to call them instruments so I don't misquote it, are vibrating. Let's see what it looks like here. That, I don't know if they drew individual frames for each vibration and just kept cycling. Maybe that's what they did. They probably just drew 3 to 4 frames of different instruments that are vibrating, but that's such a cool effect. I wonder if there are actual real high school teams that adopted some of these. There's the zombie conductor. It would be interesting to see how Inari plays without their band. You can feel that. It kind of reminds me of Brazil. Brazilian volleyball teams. This is what it feels like to be swallowed up by the Brazilian aura. Oh. Sick. Yes. Tanaka's sister coming in with the band. Don't forget to check out our Elevate apparel store, where we offer a variety of cool t-shirts like this Elevate volleyball shirt, long sleeves, tank tops, joggers, and masks. You can use the discount code below to get 5% off your entire purchase. Also, if you've been enjoying these reaction videos, please consider supporting me on Patreon, where you'll get early access to these Haikyuu reaction videos, as well as our official volleyball games. I have a private blog and a podcast and other cool exclusive content, and you can sign up for the Patreon linked below. Now let's get back to the Fat Bird. Still struggling. I can see how they wanted to save money by having simpler halftime scenes. Instead of having to animate a brand new sequence of people serving at balls. Wow, 2 aces out of 7 points. That's pretty good. I like that, keeping the team focused, even though they're up. Good move by the coach. Who's this K-pop looking guy? He had some sleepy eyes. Oh, there we get with the... They recycled that scene. You can't get anything past me here. So these are just still images from the illustrator. You draw one really nice scene and you have the camera panning down left to right, zooming in and out to kind of make you feel like there's motion. And then you got the vibrating instruments there. Recycled scene. Yes. Oh, this is so sick. We got Taiko. They got a lot of people. That's some fancy movement.
Maniatte kurete yokatta.
Man, that's sick. Well, that came just in time. Hey, it didn't go through Haran's whole serving routine. Oh, Kageyama can do that too. That's the same move that Atsumu did, where he set the quick set blind. It definitely saved all the best animation for this episode. This is some... These are complex movements that they're animating so fluidly. I wonder how they're gonna deal with this. Maybe they're gonna mess up with Inari. What's she referring to? Did she get in a fight with one of the cheerleaders? So this doesn't make sense, because if they're playing while Karasuno is about to serve, I think Inari's team is also playing, so wouldn't they compete? Because all Inari has to do is just start messing up the other team's rhythm. Man, I want that trench coat. Standing float. Hey, at least it's in.
Double quick.
He's gonna get hit in the face again after he reads it. Oh, he's reading. But I think it's so funny how Nishino is licking his lips. Even better, Hinata gets a lucky foot dig, but he's in the right spot. Wow, that's the first facial expression you get from the ref. Even he was surprised. This happens more often than you think. Especially for people that have to dig down the line or the sharp angle so fast. Of course, Nishinoya respects that. Is he gonna do that back real quick? Is he gonna do it? Oh, double quick to Daichi. Oh, that was a sick play. Even I was fooled on that one. This is so cool. They do a double quick set and Karasuno comes right back to them. Yeah, when you're that early, you gotta commit to Hinata, otherwise he's just gonna get an open net. The mind games across the net of high-level players. Interesting explanation. Let's see what he's talking about. The reason why this play was particularly effective, I've actually never seen a back row quick used to the same level of decoy to open up the right side, unless you're setting an insanely fast tempo. And I call this the mistempo. In order to execute the mistempo, you want to line up your hitters very close to each other so it looks like you're barely missing the other player, and that makes it very, very deceptive. This is more commonly run in the front row, where you saw that from Inari, where the middle is running a 3 or a shoot to the left side, and then the outside hitter is running a very quick set to their left side. So it looks like the setter's barely missing the middle, and then right when it crosses over the middle, the outside hitter is right there to crush the ball. So it's really cool that they were able to do this from the back row to the right front. I do believe it's possible. I just haven't seen this in real life. Yeah, it's like a miss set.
Hinata's
This is really cool commentary from the other players too. He has all these funny conversations in his head. He's cute. That is true. You just gotta approach it one point at a time. 2-point game. Hitoshi. Who is Hitoshi? The dual wield, maybe someone who can hit a topspin and a float in the air. But you can't tell. It's hard to execute. But if you can do it well, it's very, very difficult to read. Especially if you can make the whole approach look exactly the same, the toss is the same. Because in order to pass the topspin serves that are coming so fast, you have to stand further back. But then to pass in a float serve effectively, you want to step closer to the net. Oh, let's see what the... This is cool insight. So he starts further back. Wow, Coach Ukai. That is the downside of being on TV, is people get to study you. Good job, Coach Ukai. Okay, that's 4 steps. I think I counted correctly. Okay. I wouldn't move up until the last second because otherwise you're letting the server know that you know what they're doing. Okay, yep. Float serve. Oh, but it's still deadly. Oh. Okay, because he's hitting it at a really fast pace, which is hard to do, and Nishinoya is not good at hand passing. Service ace hat! Man, Nishinoya, you gotta figure out how to pass with your hands soon. Man, something is up with the text tracking, the translations. Usually it's really smooth, but they're totally vibrating. I hope it's not going to be like this for the rest of the episodes there. Good words, as always, from Captain Daichi. Miss a chance to score. Are they gonna do the X play or some weird crossing pattern stuff? I think there are. Because the music just got very intense. So they're probably gonna serve tough, earn a free ball, and then run their twin play. Okay, got it with his hands. Dig, are they gonna do it? Yes, they are. Oh, but Kageyama's gonna remember from the hitting lines. Such beautiful animation here. Oh! They did exactly what Hinata and Kageyama did, just even better. Wow, the fluidity of the hair flowing. The ball settling. One suggestion I've definitely taken from you guys is if I like a scene, don't be afraid to rewatch it. And I'm gonna rewatch this scene here to appreciate. Man, just the movement. Look at that. When Kageyama just. The hair flows there. I'm more impressed with the hair animation in these scenes here. That cloud explosion from the ball setting. That was a beautiful scene. Samu. So that's the twin's name. I thought they were going to do some crossing pattern from the warm-up. I thought that would have been a little cooler. Oh, this is a new track. Alright, we got a new outro, so I'm going to watch this one. TV, oh, this is where Hinata first got his inspiration looking at the little giant. Now Karasuno's on TV, how cool is that? Alright, they kind of degraded the quality to make it look like you're watching it on a mobile device or a TV. Other schools watching Karasuno. Man, who would have thought that from season one? There's that tall middle guy. Not a lot of animation going on here. This is an interesting style. It's just still images that are panning. Maybe they're, that's Josai. Maybe they're cheering on Karasuno. I like the style though. Even though they're not animating, I like the variety of high quality still images that they're putting in. Then we got the principal with his toupee all messed up. We got the protective crow looking at the cat, the Koma cat. That's a cute cat. I never really liked cats until I met my wife. She converted me into a cat person and now I have two cats. And that's why I'm sneezing all the time. I like the outro, like kind of a little more calm and peaceful. Uh-oh, don't want to do spoilers here. Here's my immediate reaction to episode 14. These are my favorite types of episodes where they dive deep into almost every single point, and I think this entire episode only spanned maybe 5 or 6 points because the game started last episode, and how much detail and how much inner thought they were able to go through between what Karasuno was thinking and what Inari was thinking. Also, you throw in the commentary from the other volleyball players watching, like Hoshiyumi, Bokuto, and you even get the crowd involved. And the storyline for this episode was so complex. They also go into the varying rhythms and how the band can mess up the rhythm of the servers, and so much back and forth that this was just such a beautifully scripted episode. We haven't seen Tsuki in a while. My guess is that he's gonna make a big impact in this game because he's been working on his maximum reach and he's one of the smarter players. And that was a really cool moment where he was about to serve and he was laughing to himself because he was able to block out the crowd and he was smirking at the fact that he knew they couldn't get to him. And that's gotta be a sign that he's gonna play a big role because he's able to rise above the pressure of this big match and not get distracted by the Inari band. Another cool surprise was Tanaka's sister coming in with the Taiko team. I think it would be cool to see the battle between Tanaka's sister's band and Inari's band kind of go back and forth and see what kind of battles they can have. Don't forget to catch up on all my other reaction videos by clicking on the playlist right here, and I'm sure you're gonna love this video right here.